Hi again, YouTubers. This is a review of the Sephora number 41 brush. I'm pretty sure that's it. Yep, the round powder brush. And this was requested by SA1993. This brush is actually a round powder brush, and it is a Sephora professional brush. Says it right here on the brush. Just to tell you a little bit about this brush, is this is a really big, round, fluffy brush. It is very soft, but it is also dense. Like, you don't see it going down when I'm pushing on it like this. This is great for an all-over type of thing. I use it on my Makeup Forever HD powder. When I'm done all of my makeup, I just kind of brush it over once really quickly, pretty easily, just for a really big fluffy brush. I will say it sheds a little bit. Don't know why. It's shedding on me right now. My MAC brushes don't shed. This one does shed. It's about $38 at Sephora. The last time I looked, it had a, online they have brown bristles on it, but in the store it has white bristles. So not really sure what the differences are there or why it is different. But to compare it to a couple other things, now MAC does have a brush that's a number 150 that is $42, and it is probably the only brush that they have that is similar to this. I don't think it's quite this big again. However, it is their big fluffy brush. And with this one being 38 and the other one being 42, only $4 difference. You'd have to look at it and see what the difference is in size. I don't have one here to match it up. That's one of my next couple brushes, but if the MAC one doesn't shed, which my MAC ones usually don't, it might be worth the extra couple dollars. It also depends on the size. I don't know if it's as big as this one. Couple other brushes that MAC has that are the only things that I have that could be even remotely comparable are totally different is the MAC 182, and this is a kabuki brush. As you can tell, total difference in size, like I said. Besides, the kabuki is made to be very dense as well so that you can buff in. This one isn't made as well for buffing because of the size of it. It is more for an overall powder brush. The MAC 134 is another big brush that they have, but again, this is totally different. See how thin this is this way? This is more for a bronzer, for going along your cheekbones such as that. So far I have not run into another brush that is similar to this Sephora brush, the number 41. It's a really, really super soft brush, and it's really nice. It has a super long handle. If you see the difference in that as well. There's a good difference in size there. But it overall for the 30, and by the way, this one here, the 182 is $45 and the 134 is $52. Now keep in mind, they're totally different uses, but all of the costs are anywhere from that $38 to like 52, this one being the least expensive of all of them. So if you are looking for an all over just translucent powder brush, I'm sure this could also be used, by the way, for putting on like a Studio Fix powder. Where is it? My MAC Studio Fix powder. If you just do a quick swipe over that, again, can be used just to take the shine off of your face for setting your makeup. That's what I think this is best for, is just a quick set of your makeup, and it'll be really good. I don't think you're gonna use it for a whole lot. You're not gonna use it for blush, you're not gonna use it for mineralize, you're not gonna use it for any of those type of things. So overall, this is a great brush. I really like it except for the shedding. The shedding kind of bothers me. But I would say for $38, it's totally worth it. Try Sephora store when you're in there and feel it. Feel how soft it is. It is really nice. If you have ever felt the MAC 182, it's very similar in feelings to this brush. So when you're in Sephora, give it a feel, see what you think. Think of it, see it, if it's worth it for you. And if you're online, take a look at it. It's definitely a brush that's all on its own. Never seen one like this. So I hope you enjoyed this. And if you have any questions or comments, please put them below. And don't forget to comment, rate, and subscribe. Thanks so much, guys, and have a great day.